Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 16 has been out for a few months, and they've released a bunch of different versions since the initial release with iOS 16.1, 16.1.1, 16.2, and more in the future all the way up to iOS 17. I wanted to share some iOS 16 tips and tricks you should know. If we go into Photos, we'll tap on any photo here, press and hold. I'm sure you're already familiar with that you can crop the background out instantly. You can go over maybe into Notes, just let go, and it drops over there. However, if you want to do this multiple times, it can take a little bit of time and be time consuming, but Apple actually has a way to do this quickly. So if we select all of the different images within this folder here of favorites, and then we go to Share, under Share, if we scroll down and Save to Files, and then create maybe a folder. I have one here, cropped images, and then we'll just save it to these images. Give it just a moment to save. We'll go over into that file and you can see all of the different images here. If we tap on the three dots in the upper right, you can see here that if we select all of them, we'll just select all of them here and then go to the menu in the bottom right. Now we have the option to automatically remove the background from all of them. Tap on Remove Background, give it just a moment to process, and it should remove the background from all of them, creating new images with the background removed on all of them. Now, of course, it's going to be as accurate as possible, but you'll see here with the Brooklyn Bridge, it did keep some of the sky there. If we go to the next one, you'll see there's the Mac Pro. The next one, well, it's one of my old cars, and the background is sort of cropped out accurately. Again, another car I had in the past. And it does a pretty good job. Sometimes it's not 100% accurate, but on the iPhone, it did a great job. It completely removed the background. So that's a quick way if you want to quickly edit all of your different photos and remove the background on all of them. Now, something else that's new in Photos is if we go into Photos, go to your albums and scroll to the bottom. You'll see here that we have duplicates. Now, duplicates only shows up if you have duplicates. If you don't, it won't even be there. And so if we go into that, we can quickly merge different duplicates. Just tap on merge, merge the two items that are unique. It merges them all together. So that's a really nice way to go through different things, make sure they're the same, and then merge them or delete them or say that it's not the same. Also, if we go back into albums, you'll see here that we have hidden and recently deleted that are locked. So those are locked by default now, and you'll need your Face ID or password to get into those. If we go into messages, within messages, if we delete a conversation and we really didn't mean to do that, we want to get that back, we have up to 40 days to do that now. Now you can do that by going into your filters and seeing different options. However, if you're not seeing this, you need to enable a setting. So if we go into settings, and within settings, if we scroll down to where it says messages, within messages, scroll to the bottom, you'll see filter unknown senders. Make sure this is turned on or you won't see those options. Now, once this is enabled, go back into messages. And if we tap on filters in the upper left, you'll see all messages, known senders, unknown senders, unread messages, and recently deleted. Go into recently deleted and you can recover those. One big feature that many people really like with iOS 16 isn't turned on by default. If we go into settings and then we go to sound and haptics, scroll down, you'll see that we actually have keyboard feedback. This is something that many people have had as far as sound for a while, but now we have haptic feedback. Now, most people know about this, but there's still many people I find that still didn't know this was there. Once this is enabled, when you go into an app, whether that be Notes or anything else, when you type and say, "Hi, how are you today?" you actually can feel every single tap of the keyboard, and it's letting you know that you're actually pressing something. So it's haptic feedback, and it's something I highly recommend you try out. Of course, you can turn it off if you don't like it. It will use a little bit of your battery, but to me, the nice feature is actually worth using a little bit of battery to move the little haptic feedback motor with the haptic engine. Now, if we go back into Photos, you'll see that we have those same photos in my favorites. If I go into one and then select edit, we'll give it a second to load. We can edit this photo, and I'm sure you're familiar with that. But maybe let's make it super overexposed. We'll give it a bunch of brilliance here. So now you can see that it's very bright. If we hit done, give it a second to load again, tap the three dots in the upper right. And now if we tap on copy edits, we can copy these edits and paste them on other photos. So if we select all of the different photos in this favorites album, beside the one I just edited, then again, go to the three dots in the bottom right. Now we can actually paste those edits and you'll see everything brightens just like it did before. Now you can go back into these and revert this back to how it was before by going into Edit and then tap on Revert, and then it will go back. But you can copy and paste edits across the OS into hundreds of photos if you wanted to. So if you had a preset you sort of liked on one photo, you can easily copy and paste those to others. One thing I also find really helpful that's not only in photos but throughout the OS has to do with it understanding different information on a screen and allowing you to easily convert that. So here's a screenshot of the weather today in the forecast, and you'll see tomorrow it's 60 degrees Fahrenheit. However, many people that watch these videos are not from the United States and they use Celsius. So if I want to convert 60 degrees Fahrenheit to Celsius, tap on Convert Fahrenheit, and you'll see that's 15.56 degrees Celsius or 288.71 degrees Kelvin. I use this all the time to convert different things and also translate text as well. So if we go into Safari, within Safari, you'll see this is the French version of a website. And if we press and hold here, and select this text, and then slide over, you'll see we can translate. We'll translate it into English, and you'll see it here. Can't find the Tesla you're looking for. You can hit play, and it will actually play that out. We'll try it again.
Can't find the Tesla you're looking for.
And again, it plays that out in the voice you've chosen for Siri. And so that's something that's really helpful across the whole OS, whether that be translating or recognizing different things that can be converted, whether that's currency or degrees and everything else. It will actually recognize a lot of those things. With iOS 16, we gained an all new lock screen, fully configurable with widgets and more. And if we press and hold, and go over and add a new wallpaper. And at the top, we have Photo Shuffle, and you can change your wallpaper throughout the day or every time you lock your phone. So if we tap on this, you can also find it if you scroll down. Within this option, you'll see that we can shuffle these photos based off of people, nature, or cities that I have in my photo library. We can also change the frequency to change hourly, daily, on lock, or on tap. So if we change it to on lock, tap on Use Featured Photo. Now we can set our widgets. We'll just hit Add for now, give it a moment to save, and we'll wait for it to save. There we go. We'll just tap Set Wallpaper Pair, and now it's set. Now every time I lock the phone, unlock it, it will change. Again, lock the phone, unlock it, and it changes the background based on whatever you set. It can change every hour, every tap, or every lock. And I think that's a great addition. Also on the lock screen, if we wake up the phone, pull down from the middle, we actually have Spotlight Search. You can unlock to see your recent results. So again, let's try that out. It'll unlock, and then we can see our result. When we pull down, you'll see things that I recently searched for. That can also be disabled if you'd like within your settings, but it's an easy way to get to things that I don't think people realize is there unless they activate it by mistake. So we could search for Apple, and it will search directly on the lock screen, making it a little faster to get to whatever we want. If we want to go to the Apple Store, the phone needs to be unlocked, and then it will load directly to the Apple Store. Now, specifically on the iPhone 14 Pro and 14 Pro Max, there's some interactions with the Dynamic Island I don't think most people are aware of. So if we open something up, such as music, we'll hit play, swipe up, it goes into the Dynamic Island. If we swipe our finger to the right on the Dynamic Island, it goes away. Swipe back to the left, and whatever was playing comes back. So if we don't want to see something in the top, it won't show if we just swipe it away. However, this works for multiple apps as well. So if we go into the clock, we'll just start a timer here. That also goes into the Dynamic Island. If we swipe to the right, it switches to the second app. Swipe to the right again, it goes away. Swipe left, it comes back. Swipe left again, and it goes away. Again, swipe again, and it shows both different apps in the Dynamic Island. So you'll see that interaction changes, goes back and forth depending on what you want to see. Of course, the taps just go back into the apps like they always do, but that's something I don't think most people are aware of. Now, if we go into settings and then we go down to accessibility, under accessibility, if we go to touch, scroll down, and you'll see a new option for prevent lock to end call. This is something that I think should have been there for a long time. If we enable this, you'll see it says prevent the side button from ending the current call. If you're on a phone call and found you've accidentally disconnected it over and over just by pressing the power sleep wake button, this will fix that problem and finally stop you from hanging up on the person you were talking to. That's something that I would like to see in the main menu, but it's found in accessibility. And so hopefully those are some things that you didn't know with iOS 16 that might help you use iOS 16 a little bit better on your latest iPhone or whatever device you're using it on. Most of these tips apply across iPad as well, and let me know if there's any that you didn't know or maybe some that you think other people should know that they don't know. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.